Na, tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the travels of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, who traveled into the spiritual world.
我们一直在讲述的是Gopakumar的历程，他是Govardhan山的一个牧牛童，他旅行到了灵性世界。And
he went to Vaikuntha, and then he went to Dwarka, and in Dwarka he met with Uddhava, and then Narada Muni came there.
他旅行到了Vaikuntha，然后进而又去了Dwarka。 在多尔卡他遇见了乌德瓦，然后之后呢，Narada Muni 来了。
And Narada Muni had a long talk with Gop Kumar and Uddhava in the home of Uddhava, and they talked about Krishna.
Narada Muni 呢就在乌德瓦的家中呢，跟乌德瓦和Gopa Kumar 进行了长时间的谈话，谈到了 Krishna。
Narada Muni was speaking about Krishna's pastimes in Gokul. Gokul means in this world, on this planet.
Narada Muni 呢就谈到了 Krishna 在Gokul的逍遥, Gokul是在这个星球上的地方。
So we had how Krishna performed many wonderful pastimes, about how he lifted the Govardhan hill, and then he showed the spiritual world to all the people in Vrindavan. So Narada Muni says to Gop Kumar, he said, just by hearing about these pastimes of Krishna, you can understand how there's nothing to equal them anywhere in this world. It's the most wonderful thing.
Narada Muni 就对Gopakumar说，仅仅是通过聆听这些事迹，你就能够明白，在这个世界上，它是无可匹敌的，它是至为奇妙的。
And devotees, when they just simply hear about Krishna's pastimes, it will awaken their love for Krishna in their heart. Especially the pastimes of Krishna in Vrindavan, they're much greater than the pastimes of the Lords in any other incarnation.
尤其是在Vrindavan，Krishna在Vrindavan的逍遥时光，要比Krishna其他化身的显现的逍遥时光更加伟大。Vrindavan
pastimes begin like with the when Krishna kills Putana, and just hearing about this pastime also awakens love in the heart.
Krishna在Vrindavan的逍遥时光是始于他杀死了女巫Putana，仅仅是聆听了这个逍遥时光呢，就能唤醒心中的爱了。
Yeah, so we just hearing about them awakened love, if we think about them deeply within our heart, if we think about Krishna's pastimes deeply, we'll feel even more love for Krishna.
我们仅仅是聆听这个消失光就有这么大的效力，如果我们在内心深深的来去冥想，这个消失光就能有更大的效力。
It's just that there's a special power in hearing about the pastimes of Krishna, which awakens this love.
冥想着 Krishna 的消逝光有着特殊的力量，它能唤醒一个人内心的爱。
And if somebody is able to use logical arguments to tell people about or to understand Krishna's pastimes and Krishna's glories, then that person is very fortunate.
倘若一个人能够运用逻辑分析，或者是一个人可以告诉别人 Krishna 消失光，或者他真正明白了 Krishna 消失 Krishna 的荣耀，那么这样的一个人是至为幸运的人。
And some people.They're maybe so fortunate they just hear a few words about Krishna's pastimes and their love awakens.
有的人是如此的幸运，仅仅是听到了 Krishna 消失光的只言片语，对 Krishna 的爱就被唤醒了。
Yeah, we see this in Lord Chaitanya's pastimes. Some devotees like that.
我们在主 Chaitanya 的消逝光当中就看到了有这样的几位奉献者。
Yeah, when Lord Nityananda first came to Mayapur, the devotees, Lord Chaitanya came with all of his devotees, and they didn't know who was Lord Nityananda. They had not seen him before.
当主 Nityananda 他初次来到 Mayapur 的时候。当时呢，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和一些奉献者就在 Mahaprabhu， 奉献者并不认识主 Nityananda 是谁。
So Lord Chaitanya, he told Srivas Pandit, he said, recite some verse about Vrindavan.
主 Chaitanya 就告诉 Srivas Pandit， 命令他来背诵 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的逍遥时光。
So, Srivas Pandit began to recite a beautiful Sanskrit verse from the 10th canto, describing the beauty of Krishna as he enters the Vrindavan forest.
Srivas Pandit 就开始背诵《圣严伯加瓦坛》第十篇当中一些梵文诗节，描述当 Krishna 进入 Vrindavan 森林的时候 ，Krishna 的美丽。
And when Lord Nityananda heard this verse, then he just became like a madman, and he began to cry, and he rolled on the ground, and he was just shedding tears, and he flooded the whole floor with his tears.
一听到这些诗节，主尼天南的就立刻变得像疯子一样。他就泪如雨泻，开始在地上打滚，然后他的泪水呢就浸湿了整个的地板。
So all the devotees could understand, whoa, he's really a great devotee.
所有的奉献者看到这一幕场景就明白了，哦，他真的是一个伟大的奉献者。
And then another time, this one devotee named Pundarik Vijayanidhi, he came to Mayapur, and the devotees, devotee Mukunda, told Gadarhar that the great devotee has come. You should come and see him.
还有一次呢，是 Pundarik Vijayanidhi 就来到了 Mayapur。Mukunda 呢就把这一消息告诉了 Gadadhar， 告诉他说来了一位伟大的奉献者，你应当去见他。
So when Gadadhar came and saw him, he thought, no, he can't be a very good devotee. He looks like a materialist.
原来见到了彭德瑞克之后呢，他心里就想，哦，这个不可能是一个好奉献者，他看上去像个物质主义者。
Because he was dressed very nicely and he had lots of rings on his fingers and he was he looked very opulent.
因为他亨德瑞克维加尼迪呢身着华丽的衣饰，每个手指头上都戴着戒指，看上去呢是过着一种富裕的生活。
So Gadadhar was thinking, because Gadadhar's very renounced, he thought he couldn't be a good devotee. But then Mukunda sang a song from the Srimad Bhagavatam, a beautiful verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam.
因为格达达尔呢是过着非常气绝的生活，所以他就断定这个不是一个很优秀的奉献者。这时候呢，姆昆达就开始背诵圣典博加瓦坛当中的一首美丽的诗节。
Aho bhagyam stanatralakutam jagam sampayanadapya sarvi. Like this is a beautiful verse in the 10th canto which describes about Krishna being very merciful, that he.Accepted Putana as his mother, although she came with poison on her breast to kill him. But Krishna delivered her to the spiritual world to be his mother.
Krishna.但是却被 Krishna 拯救了，并且回到灵性世界，作为了 Krishna 的母亲之一。
And when Pundarik heard this verse, his love for Krishna awoke, and he became ecstatic, and he began to roll on the ground, and he was crying and crying for a long time.
当 Pundarik 听到了这个诗节之后。他内心的爱就立刻被唤醒了，他就立刻陷入了狂喜，开始在地上不断的打滚，而且不停的哭泣，哭了很长的时间。
So Gadadhar understood, wow, he's really a great devotee. He's really a good devotee. And Gadadhar took initiation from him, became his disciple.
格达达尔便明白了，哦，这真的是伟大的奉献者。于是呢，他便从他那里获得了启迪，成为他的门徒。
Okay, so Narada Muni goes on. He says, "It's difficult for me to be able to even speak about the next topic." Because it's Krishna's dearest possession.
Narada Muni said, "It's difficult for me to say this topic because it's Krishna's possession."
Yeah, it's the most valuable of Krishna's possessions. It's his dearmost possession.
Narada Muni 说，对我来说，要谈论这些。话题是非常难的，因为这是 Krishna 最珍爱的财富。
Yeah, this possession is always in Krishna's hands.
这些财宝总是在 Krishna 的手心里。
And it's only Krishna who's able to actually make use of this possession.
只有 Krishna 才能够利用这些财宝。
We're talking about Krishna's flute. It's the most valuable of all Krishna's possessions.
我们在谈的是 Krishna 的笛子，它是 Krishna 最珍爱的一个宝贝儿。
Because when Krishna plays the flute, it attracts all the gopis to come and join in the rasa dance.
因为当 Krishna 吹起他笛子的时候，吸引了所有牧牛姑娘都加入他的 Rasa 之舞。
And even after the Rasa dance, the gopis are still hearing the sound of Krishna's flute in their minds.
甚至在 Rasa 之舞结束之后，那些牧牛姑娘 在脑海里还萦绕着 Krishna 的笛音。
Even the demigods, they're traveling in the sky, and they, with their husbands, and they also become amazed.
甚至那些和他们的丈夫一起在天上旅行的半神人们，见到 Krishna 的消失光，也都惊讶的目瞪口呆。
Yeah, when the ladies, these demigods, the wives of these demigods, they're with their husbands.They're flying in their special airplanes, and their minds, they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, and they become lusty. Hearing the sound of Krishna's flute, they become lusty, the lusty desires awaken.
那些正在跟自己的丈夫们一起乘坐着飞机在天空翱翔的那些天堂的女士们，他们听到 Krishna 动听的笛音之后，内心的色欲也立刻被唤醒了。
So everything about Krishna's flute is very special. There's no other object like it in this world.
跟 Krishna 的笛子有关系的一切都是独一无二的，在这个世界上没有任何一个事物能跟它比拟。
To understand the greatness of this flute, we have to hear about the effects its sound produces.
为了明白这个笛子的伟大之处，我们必须要明白它的笛音所造成的效果。
Only Krishna can own this flute.
才能够拥有这支笛子。
And Krishna takes every opportunity to allow the flute to taste the nectar of his lips.
而且 Krishna 他利用每一个机会，允许这支笛子能够享受他唇上的甘露。
So Narada Muni is trying to say something about the flute.It's not easy for him.
Narada Muni 是想现在，试图描述这个笛子，但是这对他来说是太难办的事了。
So Narada Muni says, the Upanishads, the words of the Upanishads and the other Vedas, they come from the Lord's own mouth.
Narada Muni 说。奥义书还有韦达经是出自于 Krishna 的莲花口。
But when that flute, that wooden flute is put to the lips of Krishna, then it creates a sound which is more sweeter, more nectar than the words of the Vedas.
当这根木质的笛子放在 Krishna 的唇上的时候，他创造出的声音比韦达经还要更加甜美，更加甘醇。
So Narada Muni feels jealous of the flute because it has such an intimate relationship with Krishna.
Narada Muni 开始变得嫉妒这根笛子了，因为他跟 Krishna 有着如此亲密的关系。
That's why he calls it, that's why he says wooden object. Of course, it's a very, very special flute.
所以他称这根笛子为一个木头的，为一个木头的对象，但实际上它是非常的特殊的。
So the demigods and the demigods and their wives, when they hear the sound of the flute,They all become bewildered.
当半神人们和他们的妻子听到这个笛音之后，都困惑了。
Even demigods like Indra and Shiva and Brahma, they get so confused. They cannot think what is real and what is illusion. They forget.
Shiva Brahma 这样的伟大半神人一听到这个笛音之后都变得困惑，他们想不起来什么是对的，什么是错误的。
Because the demigods are flying over Vrindavan, they're watching Krishna's pastimes, but then they hear the sound of the flute and they become bewildered.
因为半神人们他们飞过 Vrindavan 的上空的时候听到了这个笛音之后就变得困惑不解。
And the wives of the demigods all become lusty. The lust in their heart awakens. They become so much affected by the sound of the flute.
而这些半神人们的妻子们听到这个笛音之后呢就变得内心的色欲被唤醒了，因为他们受到这个笛子的影响。
Because Krishna, of course, he's all attractive, and his beauty and his character attracts all the women.
Because Krishna is the most attractive one, his beauty, his character attracts all the women.
So when they see him and when they hear him playing the flute, then they become so bewildered that the flowers in their hair all fall down.And the belts which they're wearing around their waist all become loose.
当他们听见 Krishna 吹奏笛子的时候，他们变得非常的受到迷惑，他们头上的鲜花的饰物都纷纷的从头上掉下来，而他们腰上的腰带也变得松散了。
In the beginning, they're a little far away from Vrindavan, so they can only hear the sound faintly. But as they get closer to Vrindavan, they hear the sound more and more, more clear. Then they become more and more bewildered.
一开始呢，因为他们离 Vrindavan 还有一段距离，所以只能隐隐约约地听到笛音。但是随着他们离 Vrindavan 越来越近，笛音越来越清晰。他们变得越来越迷惑。
Krishna can play his flute. He's got many new styles of playing the flute, which unlike anybody else.
Krishna 呢可以以各种各样的方式来吹起他的笛子。
So his the melodies which he will play.The different tunes, they're so attractive, they confuse the minds of Brahma and Shiva.
他笛子的旋律，笛音的旋律，还有这些曲调是这么有吸引力，就迷惑了，困惑了 Brahma 和 Shiva 的心意。
When Brahma and Shiva hear the sound of Krishna's flute, they just bow their heads and they bow their heads and they fix their mind on Krishna.
当 Brahma Shiva 听到 Krishna 的笛音之后，就低下了头，向他顶礼，并且把心意专注于他。
They forget their own position. They forget their identity. They're not able to remember who they are.
忘记了自己的身份，他们不知道自己是谁。
They wonder who is the absolute truth. They thought previously they thought Brahman was the absolute truth, but when they hear the sound of the flute, then it becomes something. The truth is maybe this is greater than than what they know of the absolute truth.
他们不知道绝对真理到底是谁了。以前他们以为。Brahman 是绝对真理，但是当他们听到这个笛音的时候呢，他们认为这个比他们之前意识到的那个绝对真理更加伟大。
And the sound of Krishna's flute breaks the meditation of the great yogis and sages.
Krishna 的笛音。
And they feel ecstasy awakening. They feel the ecstasy awakening from the sound of the flute.
由于这个笛音，他们狂喜的爱就被唤醒了。
And when Krishna plays the flute, even the moon and the other planets, which are all moving, they just stop.
而且当 Krishna 一旦吹起他的笛子的时候，那些运行着的月亮和星星们都停止了运行。
Even the impersonalists become attracted by the sound of Krishna's flute.
甚至那些非人格主义者也受到 Krishna 笛音的吸引。
And they can experience all the symptoms of ecstatic love for Krishna, although they're impersonalists. They had no hope of experiencing it. But by the mercy of Krishna, they can experience.
而且他们本来他们是没有希望能够体验到 Krishna 的仁慈了，但是当他们听到这个笛音的时候，他们就由于 Krishna 的仁慈，他们也有所体验。
So not only the wives became agitated, but everybody is affected by the sound of Krishna's flute. Not only the wives of the demigods flying in the airplanes, but even the planets were affected, and the Mayavadis, the impersonalists were affected. They were all completely overwhelmed by the sound of Krishna's flute.
那些乘坐着飞机跟他们丈夫旅行的半神的妻子听到了这个笛音就变得激动起来，而且每一个生物都受到影响，包括那些星系，还有那些假象宗主义者，还有非人格主义者，他们因为听到 Krishna 的笛音都纷纷受到了影响。
So the gopis, of course, they experience the greatest effect because they have the greatest love for Krishna.
And 那些牧牛姑娘，她们受到的影响是最大的，因为她们对 Krishna 怀着的爱是最伟大的。
So the people of Vrindavan, they give everything for Krishna. They dedicate everything for Krishna. Their bodies.Their family, their property, everything, even their self.
那些 Vrindavan 的居民，他们把一切都献给了 Krishna， 他们的身体、他们的家、他们的财产，甚至他们自己都献给 Krishna。
And they don't worry about their own needs, and they don't think about.Being successful in this world, or they're not even thinking about the next life. But the people, the cowherd men, they had so much respect for Krishna.That they would bow down to their own wives because their wives, they knew their wives were very dear to Krishna.
甚至那些牧牛郎，他们就会顶拜自己的妻子，因为他们知道，Krishna 更喜爱他们，对 Krishna 来说，他们的妻子是更为珍贵的。
So, not only people who didn't know much about Krishna were affected by the sound of Krishna's flute, but Krishna's family and friends, they were also affected.
不仅那些对 Krishna 不甚了解的人受到 Krishna 的笛音的影响，甚至 Krishna 的家人、朋友也受到笛音的影响。
These people of Vrindavan would give, they would just consider everything as Krishna's property and for the pleasure of Krishna.
Vrindavan 的这些人们，他们把一切都看成是 Krishna 的财产。
Even the old gopis and the young gopis, they're all very dear to Krishna.
无论那些年长的 gopi 还是年轻的 gopi 牧牛姑娘，都受到 Krishna 的影响。
All the gopis they belong to Krishna. They're meant for Krishna's and Krishna's pleasure.
所有的 gopi 们，他们都属于 Krishna。他们的存在都是为了 Krishna 的快乐而存在的。
They don't think about their own pleasure. They only think what is for Krishna's pleasure.
他们不考虑自己的快乐，他们只考虑 Krishna 的快乐与否。
And the young children, the young boys in the cowherd in the families of the cowherd men, the young boys, they were very attached to Krishna.
诞生在那些牧牛郎家庭当中的年轻的 小男孩们，他们就深深地依恋 Krishna。
They were just like Krishna's shadow. If they couldn't see him, they would be so worried. They would be looking everywhere. Where is he? Where did he go? They'd feel so much distress.
他们就像 Krishna 的影子一样，一旦他们见不到 Krishna。他们立刻就担心起来了，到处寻找 Krishna， Krishna 在哪里？他们内心的就感到非常的难过。
And when Krishna would come back, then they would be so happy and they would rush to touch Krishna.
当 Krishna 回来之后，他们就立刻快活起来了，立刻就冲上前去，要去触碰 Krishna.
Because sometimes Krishna would have to leave them to go.To see something in Vrindavan or to go to look at something. And so then they would feel, oh, Krishna's gone. Where did Krishna go? They would be so worried, so much anxiety.
Because sometimes Krishna will leave. He went to Vrindavan to see other people, or he went to look for other things.他每当他这时候走开的时候，这些年轻的小男孩就会到处寻找 Krishna 在哪里 ，Krishna 在哪里？他们满帐感到非常的担心，非常的焦虑。
And when Krishna would come back, then they would all run and they would say, "I'll be the first to touch Krishna." And the other cowherd boy will say, "No, I will be the first." And they would all run and race to touch Krishna first.
每次 Krishna 回来的时候，他们立刻就奔跑起来，都会开始说：“我是第一个会碰到 Krishna 的人，我是第一个去碰到 Krishna 的人。”所以他们都会冲过去，一个比一个跑得更快。
So in this way, they were all enjoying the company of Krishna.
就这种方式，他们都在享受着 Krishna 的陪伴。
And then.You have gopis like Srimati Radharani, who she could leave her husband. Some gopis left their children and relatives. They gave up everything for Krishna.
还有像 Radharani 这位 gopi， 她离开了自己的丈夫，以及其他有的 gopi 呢是离开自己的孩子、自己的亲戚，他们放弃了一切。仅仅是为了 Krishna 的缘故。
They didn't worry about the next life. They forgot even the religious principles. And they gave up their shyness just for Krishna.
他们不考虑来世，他们甚至放弃了宗教原则，他们甚至就放弃了他们的羞涩，仅仅是为了 Krishna 的缘故。
And sometimes, of course, they would go through many difficulties. Sometimes they would lose the association of Krishna, Krishna would leave them, Krishna would play, would test them, play tricks with them, and they would be disturbed, and they would become, sometimes they would lose consciousness, or they would be stunned like a tree.
有的时候呢他们会遇到困难，有时候他们失去了跟Krishna的联谊，有时候呢 Krishna离开他们， Krishna会考验他们， 每当这时候呢他们都会感到心烦意乱，甚至有的时候他们会失去知觉，他们变得目瞪口呆，他们有的时候就像树木一样就呆住了。
So although Krishna has many queens like Rukmini in Dwarka, it's the gopis who are, and the head of the gopis, Radharani, they're the most favorite devotees of Krishna.
尽管 Krishna 在 Dwarka 城有许多的像 Rukmini 这样的皇后，但是，就是像 Radharani 这样的gopi们才是 Krishna 最被喜爱的人。
And they have so much love for Krishna that they feel the greatest ecstasy. And the gopis, just like these wives of the demigods become lusty, so the gopis also become agitated with lusty desires when they see the beauty of Krishna and when they hear him play the flute.
不仅仅是那些半神的妻子，他们听到 Krishna 的音变得色眯眯的，甚至像这些牧牛姑娘们，她们内心的这种色欲也被唤醒了。When
Krishna looks at them, then the gopis they become stunned like trees, but their hair becomes loose, and even their garments become loose.
当Krishna注视他们的时候，他们变得像树木一样，就呆滞在那里。可是他们的头发变得松散，甚至他们身上的衣服也变得松散了。The gopis,
the gopis often would complain about Krishna, but their complaints are like, in one way they're bitter, but in the other way also very sweet.
那些gopi们，他们有时候抱怨Krishna，但是呢，一方面这些抱怨显得好像很苦涩，但另一方面呢，却是非常甜美。Because
they experience some pain, but they experience also great joy from Krishna's dealings.
从Krishna跟他们的交往当中，他们体验到了 痛苦，同时又体验到了欢乐。So
when Krishna would play the flute, the people, those devotees who had love for Krishna, their love would increase hearing the sound of the flute. And those who were not devotees, they would also be attracted by the sound of Krishna's flute.
当 Krishna 吹起笛子的时候， 那些对Krishna怀着爱的人，他们的爱就会增强，而那些非奉献者们，他们听到Krishna的笛，也会被Krishna吸引。Narada
Muni said, "I will tell you the most wonderful thing. That there's animals which have no intelligence, but when they hear Krishna's flute, they just become changed."
Narada Muni 接着又说，我会将要给你们讲非常奇妙的事情。那些缺乏智慧的动物们，当他们听到这个笛子的时候，他们就会发生改变。Yeah,
they just give up their own nature. They just become, they become intelligent.
放弃了自己的兽性， 他们变得有智慧起来。
So we can understand, you know, Brijbasi people, they would become ecstatic. But it's surprising that you get foolish animals, and even lesser than foolish animals, that they also become ecstatic.
当这些 Brijbasi 们他们变得狂喜，这是可以明白的。但是当那些没有那么有智慧的动物们，甚至比动物的智慧还要低的生物，他们变得狂喜，这就令人感到惊讶了。
Yeah, in Vrindavan, you've got many cows and bulls and calves, all the village animals.
在 Vrindavan 呢，有那么多的母牛、公牛、牛犊，还有村里的那些动物们。
Yeah, animals like buffalo and sheep and goats, they're all there in the village of Vrindavan, and Krishna keeps company with them every day.
In Vrindavan, 还有除此之外还有水牛，山羊、绵羊，Krishna 呢每天都会跟这些动物相伴。
And in the forest, you've got animals like the deer.And other wild animals, so they don't see Krishna so much, but they also get some ecstasy of love of Krishna when they hear Krishna's flute.
在森林里还有鹿儿，还有野兽，他们虽然看不见 Krishna， 但是每当他们听到 Krishna 的笛音的时候。他们也会感受到由于对 Krishna 爱而感受到狂喜。
And the birds also in the forest, they also know Krishna, and they also feel the ecstasy.
在森林当中的那些鸟类，他们也知道 Krishna， 他们也开始狂喜。
And when Krishna would play the flute, then the birds, even the birds which live far away, they would come to be near Krishna.To hear the sound of the flute.
当 Krishna 吹起笛子的时候，那些住得很远的，鸟儿们，他们也纷纷的飞过来，来听 Krishna 吹笛子。
Even the trees and the bushes, they would all feel ecstasy hearing the sound of Krishna's flute.
连那些树木、灌木。当他们听到 Krishna 的笛音，也纷纷地感受到狂喜。
And even the river which is flowing, the river we don't think it has any life, but it feels life hearing the sound of Krishna's flute.
通常我们会认为河流是没有生命的，可是连这些河流们听到 Krishna 的笛音，也变得生动起来。
And even the clouds in the sky would become ecstatic hearing Krishna's flute playing.
甚至连天空的云朵听到 Krishna 吹响笛子的时候也狂喜起来。
Creatures which could move, they would become stunned and they would become still hearing Krishna's flute.
那些会动的生物听到 Krishna 的笛音，就变得呆滞起来，变得停滞起来。
And those which usually didn't move, they would move.
而那些不动的事物就变得开始移动起来。
And those creatures which had consciousness, they would lose their consciousness hearing Krishna's flute.
有知觉的生物。听到 Krishna 的音，变得失去了知觉。
And so everybody, everything was, they just changed their nature, hearing the sound of Krishna's flute.
听到 Krishna 的笛音，一切事物，他们的性质就改变了。
All this is the awakening of prema, it's the ecstasy due to love from Krishna.
由于对神 Krishna 的爱 唤醒了他们的狂喜。
The trees, which usually didn't move, they would begin to tremble, and they would start to grow new leaves, and everything would just change.
那些不动的树木听到 Krishna 的笛音就开始颤抖起来，甚至发出了新芽。
So when Krishna would go through the forest, playing on his flute.The music would cause all the living entities, everybody to be affected, to become ecstatic.
所以当 Krishna 穿过森林吹奏他的笛子的时候，一切事物都受到影响，都变得狂喜。
Now Narada Muni is going to speak a little bit about Krishna's rasa dance.
现在呢 Narada Muni 就开始讲述 Krishna 的 Rasa 初舞。
It's the most confidential of Krishna's pastimes.
Rasa 之舞是 Krishna 所有消时光当中最机密的部分。
It's the perfection of his dealings with his devotees.
这是他跟他的奉献者的交流的完美体现。
It's the highest of all of his pastimes, and it's the sweetest.
是他所有逍遥时光当中最崇高、最甜美的。
And the goddess of fortune, Lakshmi, she tried to join to enter to the dance. She made hundreds of attempts, but she was not successful.
加入这个 Rasa 之舞，并且做了上百次的尝试，但是都没有成功。
She did great austerities to get this privilege, but she couldn't get in the Rasa dance.
她从事了巨大的苦行，以便得到这样的特权，但是却没有得到允许。
The gopis, they were enjoying.Krishna embracing them with his arms, but Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, was not able to get this pleasure.
牧牛姑娘们享受着 Krishna 用他的臂膀，拥抱着他们的快乐，但是幸运女神却尝不到这样的快乐。
So not only the goddess of fortune, but even the most beautiful girls in the heavenly planets, they could not also join this rasa dance.
不仅仅是幸运女神，甚至天堂最美丽的女子也无法加入 rasa 之舞。
So just being very beautiful, that is not the qualification to enter the rasa dance.
美貌并不是进入 Rasa 之舞的资格。
So the gopis, they're more fortunate than the goddess of fortune.
因此，那些 gopi 牧牛姑娘们比起幸运女神更为幸运。
Because they have such pure love for Krishna.
她们对 Krishna 怀着纯洁无瑕的爱。
So, Krishna attracted many women of good families to join him in the forest. Like the gopis, they're from good families, and Krishna would attract them to come to the forest to dance with him.
Krishna 就吸引了那些有着很好的家庭的女子们来加入他的 Rasa 之舞，因为 Gopi 们他们都有着很好的有着非常很好的家庭，但是却被 Krishna 吸引进入了森林，跟他一起跳着 Rasa 之舞。
So Krishna was, he was very clever in speaking, and sometimes he would say things to the gopis which would give them a lot of pain.
Krishna 是善于讲话的，他很精于如何说话，所以他有他的话语，有的时候给牧牛姑娘就内心造成了痛苦。
Like sometimes the gopis, they would, and even the gopis, they would complain to Krishna about this.
有时候，勾皮们、牧牛姑娘们为此甚至，向 Krishna 抱怨 Krishna.
And one time they began to cry to Krishna.
有一次，他们就开始，在 Krishna 面前哭泣。
So at that time, Krishna showed the gopis his true feelings to them.
就那时候 ，Krishna 就向牧牛姑娘展示了他内心真实的感受。
So Krishna's main purpose in coming to this material world is so that he can enjoy these pastimes with his devotees.
Krishna 来到这个物质世界的真正的原因是跟他奉献者享受这些逍遥时光。
And he wants to also display the his special sweetness in dealing with his very intimate devotees.
他希望能够展示跟他最亲密的奉献者之间这种非常特别的甜美。
So this subject matter, this Krishna's Rasa Lila is described in the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. There are 5 chapters describing this.
So this topic is in the 圣殿薄伽瓦坛当中的第十篇描述了，有五章描述了这个主题。
So we should understand these pastimes are very confidential. We should hear the Lord's pastimes from the beginning. It's important for us to not neglect the first 9 cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam.
我们应当明白这些主题是非常机密的。我们聆听这些逍遥时光，应该从头开始聆听，不要忽视圣殿薄伽瓦坛的前面的九篇。
Because if you don't hear it properly, then you will, if you don't understand properly Krishna, then you will never understand Krishna's pastimes. We have to understand Krishna's supreme position.
Krishna 是高无上的地位。
So this rasa dance, these are very confidential pastimes of Lord Krishna, which is meant for pure-hearted devotees.
所以，主 Krishna 的这些 rasa 之舞是至为机密的逍遥时光，是指是为了那些心地纯洁。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
那我们今天早上的讲课部分就到这里。好，我们来看一下今天的问题。第一个问题是来自于 Present， 他名字叫 Present， 请问 Guru， 年长奉献者用言语、眼神动作令新人感到不舒服，导致新人心烦意心意受到打扰，这是年长奉献者的冒犯， 还是新人的冒犯？新人如果遇到这种情况，如何保护自己？I want to ask Guru, if a senior devotee, their words, their glance, and their gesture made the new people feel uncomfortable and disturb their minds, is this senior devotee's offense or new devotee's offense? So how can the new devotee protect themselves in front of this situation?
Yes, well, sometimes it's better to arrange to separate the neophyte devotees from the senior devotees, to make two groups so that they can make proper arrangements to take care of the neophyte devotees.
这样呢，可以做出更好的安排来照顾这些新奉献者。
New devotees coming to Krishna consciousness, of course, we may be very sensitive, and maybe we're maybe too sensitive, and we have to learn to be tolerant. That you know, not everybody will be.Dealing so nicely all the time with us.
嗯，who is too sensitive?
The new devotee.
Oh, okay. 当新人来到 Krishna 直觉的时候呢，他们有的时候是特别敏感，有的是甚至是过于敏感了，所以应该容忍。
You know, in the material world, there's always some difficulties in getting along with people and getting and having relationships with between devotees, just like everywhere in the material world, that sometimes it's difficult.
就是和人相处是很难的，就是在人和人之间的关系，奉献者和奉献者之间的关系，就是这个是物质世界当中呢，很难处理的关系。
We have to try to cooperate. Now, of course, older devotees, senior devotees, we would expect them to be a good example.But it's not always like that.
We 应当合作，无论老奉献者也好，新奉献者也罢，都需要给世人做出榜样。但呢，情况呢，并不都是这样子的。
All we can do is we can say we're very sorry that.Sometimes maybe somebody didn't do very nicely with you. We just ask you to be tolerant and to be concerned, simply to try to understand Krishna consciousness. Just try to take shelter of the holy name of Krishna.
我们能做到的只能是说对不起，有的时候呢，有的人呢对你不是很好，但是您得容忍，您也应该考虑，就是也会对别人呢，设身处地的加以考虑，而且呢，来到 Krishna 直觉呢，我们的目的是明白 Krishna 直觉，应该脱避于圣名。
Just like Krishna dealing with the gopis. You know, Krishna is playing the flute and all the gopis are coming running to him. And then Krishna looks at them and says, why are you coming here? What are you doing here in the forest in the middle of the night? You're young girls. Why are you coming here?
Krishna 和牧牛姑娘们，当 Krishna 深更半夜的吹响他的笛子的时候，那些牧牛姑娘就纷纷的跑到森林里来跟 Krishna 相会。可是呢， Krishna 看着他们说，你们为什么要深更半夜来到森林里呢？你们来这里做什么呢？
And the gopis look at Krishna and they think, you know, he called us, he played the flute, he was calling us to come. And now he's telling us, go back. What a rascal.
然后那些牧牛姑娘就纷纷地面面相觑，说，你吹起你的笛子，你不是你呼唤召唤我们来的呢？现在你又让我们回去，你这是什么样的一个
一个坏家伙。So Krishna does these things, so this is why we have these things here in the material world also.
所以 Krishna 就做了这件事情，所以我们在这个物质世界呢也有这种情况。
Of course, Krishna's pastimes are pure, based on pure love, but our dealings in the material world are the perverted reflection of Krishna's pure pastimes.
当然 ，Krishna 消失光都是纯爱，而我们在物质世界的交往，是灵性世界纯粹的爱的扭曲的倒影反射。
So I would advise you to find a good friend among the older, the senior devotees. Find someone who is nice and who deals with you and who you can like, who you like and who you can get along with.And just take shelter of that person.
那故事说，就建议您在年长的奉献者跟老人，从他们中间呢找一个好朋友，就是您觉得他们特别的好，这个人特别好，而且您喜欢跟他们相处，然后呢就托庇于这个人。
Now you have to understand.You may be thinking they're senior devotees, but just because they've been there a long time doesn't mean that they're very, very advanced in Krishna consciousness.
您可能呢内心就认为他这个人是年长的奉献者，但是在 Krishna 这些中待的时间年头长，并不意味着他就是在 Krishna 这些当中非常进步的。
Some people, you know, they've been around a long time, but they're not very friendly. They're not very nice.
有的人呢，他们待时间年头很长，但是呢，对别人并不友善，并不是特别好，
so,
态度并不是很好。
So don't let them, this kind of person put you off from Krishna consciousness.
不要允许这种人把你从 Krishna 知觉当中呢就是推下去。
Don't think that everybody is a pure devotee.
不要想人人都是纯粹的奉献者。
Understand, people coming to Krishna consciousness, we're all conditioned souls and we're trying to get cured.Of our conditioning, we're trying to become pure.
我们要明白，人们来到 Krishna 知觉，他们是受条件限制的灵魂，都是来得到治疗的。
Just like
他们都在努力变得纯粹。
Just like if you go to a hospital, you'll see that a lot of sick people are there.
就像你去医院，你会在医院看到很多的病人。
So, not if, some people are becoming healthy, but you know it takes time for people to get treated. Some people will take a long time to get cured.
有的人呢，他就变健康了；有的人呢，需要很长的时间才能治好病。
In the same way, people come to Krishna consciousness.It takes time for them to get over all the bad habits.
同样，人们来到 Krishna 知觉， 他们要克服那些坏习惯、坏毛病，需要时间。
Yeah, to develop, to become friendly and to become nice and sociable, it takes some time for people to change and to develop these kind of qualities.
他要让一个人呢变得友善，变得彬彬有礼，变得非常的就和人能够融洽相处，这是需要时间的。他们要改变自己的品性是需要时间。
Some people have these qualities in the very beginning. Before they become devotees, they're already very nice and sociable and friendly, and other people are not.
有的人甚至在加入 Krishna 之觉，一开始加入 Krishna 之觉，甚至呢是在加入 Krishna 之觉之前就已经是非常友善、彬彬有礼、非常的跟人相处很融洽，但是有的人不是这种情况。
We have to understand Krishna consciousness is for everyone.
我们要明白的是 ，Krishna 知觉是适合每一个人的，是给每一个人准备的。
All kinds of people, all different kinds of people, they come to Krishna consciousness.
各种各类的人，不同的人群。
So don't be put off. Just be serious and try to hear and try to find a good friend, somebody you like, somebody you can get along with, and take shelter of their company.
You mean put off means disappointed, right?
Huh? Put off? What did
yes.
I say? Yeah, means disappointed, yeah, put off.
Okay. So, 所以不要失望，您自己就变得真诚，只需要您自己真诚就好了。而且您要找到那些好的，好的人，您喜欢的人，跟他们相处就可以了。
Okay.
下一个问题，下一个问题是喜宝。顶拜咕噜老师们，请问如果在学习，请问在学习不在梵歌过程中，梵文的学习成了挑战困难，能不能暂时不学，只是理解和只是去记忆和背诵中文呢？
嗯哼。
So, 西宝妈姐pay obeisance. She said if she found that the learning Sanskrit is very difficult for her during the course of learning Bhagavad Gita, can she put aside Sanskrit only to understand and remember the Chinese?
Well, you do have to learn to chant the slokas.
您必须得学习去念诵这些十六课诗节。
Just like when we do kirtan, we sing the mantras in Sanskrit.
就像我们kirtan 的时候，这些呢，我们 kirtan 的这个 mantra 都是梵文的 mantra。
So it takes some time to learn them.
所以要去学习梵文是要花时间的。
Right.When we do Mangal Arti and we sing the song Guru Vastikam, so it takes some time to learn to sing.
比如说我们清晨的 Mangal Arti 的去唱的那些八颂铃诗也是梵文，所以学习呢要花时间。
But if you practice every day, then you can learn.
但是如果您每天都去学习怎么去唱，那就学会了。
You know Chinese pinyin, you can read pinyin.
那比如说我们中文汉字呢，它有中拼音。
你会读拼？你 Can you read the pinyin?
那姑姑问您。 拼音。
If you read Pinyin, then you can easily also gradually learn to read the Sanskrit.
因为有的就是诗歌，它是有那个拼音的，所以呢，您可以从那个拼音那个地方学习怎么发音。
Would take some time. It takes us also some time. We're not, you know, we also don't know Sanskrit. I'm from the West, so we don't know Sanskrit. So it takes years to learn to chant and to say the mantras. And I still don't say them good. You know, my Sanskrit is not good. You know, Indian people will say, oh no, not good, you know.
故事这个他是来自西方国家的，所以学习梵文也是花了好几年的时间，甚至他现在说梵文的时候也会遭到印度人的那个排斥。
Yeah, people will say, oh, my pronunciation, you know, I read Sanskrit like I'm an Englishman. It's not the same, it should be different. My pronunciation is not accurate.
然后那个他们就印度人就会说，马尔拉这的梵文发音就是西式发音，西方人的梵文发音，应该是另外不是这样的，应该是另外一种发音。
So our pronunciation may not be perfect. That's not so important.
那我们的发音可能不完美，但是发音不是最重要的。
One time, Prabhupada brought one of his disciples, a young American woman, and she had told Prabhupada, she said, I've learned to chant all the prayers from the Ishopanishad.
有一次，圣帕巴格就有一位年轻的美国的女门徒就来到印度，然后她告诉帕巴格，我已经学会了念诵。
So they had a program, and there were many people there. And Prabhupada called the girl to come on the stage, and he said, I want you to recite all the prayers you've learned. So the young American woman came on the stage and she, you know, she chanted the Ishopanishad prayers. And afterwards, you know, some Indian people there, they said, oh no, her pronunciation is not good.
然后这位年轻的姑娘就美国的姑娘就到台上就开始唱诵这个背诵这个诗节，然后过了一段时间呢，就是台下的就印度的那个男子就开始抱怨说，哦，他的发音不好。
But Prabhupada said, her pronunciation may not be very good, but her renunciation is very good.
但是帕巴德说他的发音。可能不好，但是他的气绝是好的，所以这两个英文词它后缀是很相似的。
Yeah, 对，很好，你解释很好。So Prabhupada considered renunciation more important than pronunciation.
圣帕帕德认为，就是 renunciation 就是气绝要比 pronunciation 比发音更加重要。
So, see Bao, 我们希望你的气节好，我们不靠你的发音。OK, 还有问题吗？
OK, give me a minute, I have to charge my computer.
需要我来读吗？
充一下电。
没问题。
OK， 好，那您读吧，下一个。啊，好，下一个是来自另一个问题，还是喜宝的。另一个问题就是来自我母亲，她说她每天聆听我阅读《博家梵歌》和《瓦坛》，但是让我不要逼她每天吃素念诵。请问姑姑有没有办法能够让妈妈这样的老人自己喜欢 Krishna 呢？ Another question is that my mother, every day she would listen Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam from me, but she asked me to not urge her, press her to be vegetarian and chant. So can Guru, I ask you, are there any ways to let my mother, the old mother, to like Krishna?
Well, if she's already hearing about Krishna from you, then she already likes Krishna.
如果您母亲就是已经听您讲 Krishna 了，那就意味着她已经喜欢 Krishna 了。
So just keep letting her hear.
就你就保持这种状态，就让他继续聆听就好了。
She's an older lady, not easy for her to change her habits to become a vegetarian.
她岁数大了，就让她吃素，改变这种荤食的习惯不容易。
But let her keep hearing.As much as you can.
但是，尽可能的让他去聆听。
Let her hear also kirtan. Let her hear the chanting of the holy name.
让他聆听 kirtan， 就是让他聆听圣名的唱诵。
And if she hears a lot, then she will also be chanting in her mind.
如果他就是听得多了，他在心意里也会开始跟着一起念诵唱诵。
She's already attracted because she's saying to you, she's telling you, oh, don't make me be a vegetarian, don't make me chant. That means actually she wants to, but she doesn't want to surrender.
她这么跟你说，就说不要逼我吃素，不要逼我念诵，那意思就是她想，想要吃素，想念诵，但是她还没有臣服。
OK， 下一个问题。
下一个是智敏。Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， 顶拜在场的奉献者。Krishna 的考验 ，Krishna 的考验是伴随着修行一直都有的吗？一直到死亡那一刻？The test from Krishna will accompany our practice until the moment of the death.In the moment of death, is that right?
Yes.
是的。
That's the final test, the moment of death.
死亡是最后一个期末考试。
还有问题吗？
还有下一个是这个奉献者名字叫灵魂。请问 Guru， 既然个体灵魂是平等，为什么要区别谁进步谁不进步？因为这样，那些觉得自己灵性进步的人会利用这一点，觉得批评灵性不进步的人是理所当然的。Although the individual soul are equal, why should we distinguish who is more advanced, who is not so advanced? In that way, those who felt that themselves advanced will take the advantage of it and criticize those who are not so advanced. so advanced and feel it,
yes.
Take it for granted.
Yes, you're right. Actually, nobody's really advanced. We're all equal.
是的，您说对的。我们没人是进步的，都是平等的。
But we have to organize for the sake of organization and for management. Somebody is given some position, some responsibility.
但是我们必须要组织，为了组织的缘故呢，有的人他必须得处在一个地位上，必须处在负责的地位上。
So somebody may be big leader here, but the, it doesn't mean they're spiritually, they're, it doesn't mean that, in the, that, that they're necessarily more advanced or more special than anybody else.
有的人可能在这里是一个大领导，但是这并不等同于他就一定是很进步的，他就是独特的，独一无二的。
But they take the duty to do service for Krishna. They're taking a responsibility to do service for Krishna.
但是他们承担了为 Krishna 服务的职责。
So they're given some honor because they're willing to take some risk, to take some, to take on some extra duties on behalf of Krishna.
所以他们被给予荣誉。因为他们冒险了，他们为 Krishna 承担了责任。
But we're in Krishna's eyes, we're all equal.
但是在 Krishna 眼里，我们都是平等的。
But if you do more service for Krishna, then Krishna will appreciate you more.
但是如果您为 Krishna 做更多服务 ，Krishna 会更欣赏您。
Just like Krishna gives special attention to gopis.
正像 Krishna 就特别关注那些沟皮牧牛姑娘
，because they surrendered so much to Krishna。
因为这些牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 的臣服程度最高。下一个，是来自淡然一笑 ，Krishna 的消失光这么甜美，为什么听了之后没感觉甜美呢？被世俗时光。吸引了呢，被挑别人的毛病吸引了呢，怎么改变呢？ So why Krishna's pastime are so sweet, but I don't feel the sweetness. Instead, I'm attracted to the mundane pastime and attracted to the quality to find fault with others. How can I change?
Yes.It means we have these bad habits. We have to change by doing service for Krishna.
是的，我们有这些坏毛病，我们应该通过为 Krishna 做服务来改掉这些坏毛病。
We have to start using our body and our mind and words for the service of Krishna.
我们当用我们的身体、心意、言语。
I have to do more chanting. Chanting will be very helpful to get over these bad habits.
We 应当更多的念诵，念诵可以帮助有助于一个人克服这个坏毛病。
You should not want to hear any mundane things.
您应当不想去听那些世俗的话题。
So you have to replace the mundane sound vibration with transcendental sound vibration.
应当用超然的音阵来代替世俗的音阵。
So it will take some practice. You have to practice. You have to be very determined. You have to really want to do this.
所以需要实践，需要决心，您得。真正的下决心去这么做。
Yeah, you know these things are bad. You know it's not good to talk about other people and to criticize other people, but still we do it. That's not good.
您知道就是批评别人不好是一个坏毛病，所以就不应该去这么去做。
Sometimes you just have to.Make a vow that I'm not going to talk, I'm just going to chant.
有的时候您得发誓， 我就不说话，我只念诵。
I'm just going to read the scriptures.
我仅仅是读经典。
Don't gossip.
不要闲言碎语。
You just want to hear about Krishna, nothing else.
应当只想聆听 Krishna, 别的都不听。
So, this is a very serious problem, and we have to understand the only cure is by engaging yourself more fully in the service of Krishna.
这是一个很严肃的这个是问题，毛病很严重，所以呢，我们应该通过更加完全的去为 Krishna 做服务来治疗这个坏毛病。
So this is a very bad disease. When you have a bad disease, you have to be very careful to take very intense treatment.Take the medicine the doctor gives.
所以这是一个很坏的疾病，很糟糕的疾病。我们应当小心，特别小心谨慎的去，就是特别专注的去服药。
Take the medicine and follow the diet with the medicine, or chanting Hare Krishna mantra and hearing about Krishna.
所以我们应该按照这个食谱去吃去进食，那么就是什么呢？就是唱诵 Hare Krishna， 聆听 Krishna。
And diet means only Krishna prasadam. Don't eat anything except Krishna prasadam.
饮食正确的饮食是什么呢？就是只去进食 Krishna 的 prasadam， 除了 Krishna 的 prasadam 之外，是别的什么也不吃。
Until we get over this bad habit, we cannot expect to make spiritual advancement.
除非我们克服改掉这个坏毛病，否则不要指望取得灵性的进步。
Okay, 还有问题？
下一个是灵魂，这个封建网名叫灵魂，怎么去决定一个人灵性进步呢？可以做很好的讲课，可以传教，有很多追随者，就灵性地位崇高了吗？ How can we decide who the degree of advancement? If one can lecture, give good lecture, can preach, can have many followers, does that mean that the spiritual position is sublime?
No, not necessarily.
不是，不一定。
You have to see how much they're attached to sense gratification and how much they're attached to Krishna.
需要去看他对于感官享乐的依附程度和对 Krishna 的依附程度。
Yeah, there are many very nice devotees.They don't like to give lectures, they don't like to speak, they don't like to be prominent, but they're very Krishna conscious.
有很多优秀的奉献者，他们不喜欢讲话，不喜欢去传播。They don't like to preach, right?
They don't want to be prominent in the society.
他们不想在社会上出人头地。
But they're very advanced spiritually.
但可是他们的灵性特别进步。
So you have to see the internal qualities. It's difficult to know who is actually advanced.
你得看一个人内在的品质，才能决定他的灵性的进步。Next one is from 淡然一笑。刚才听到说 Krishna 对木牛姑娘说的话，叫木牛姑娘痛苦，是灵性的吧？ 我想取悦我的爱人，结果却相反，如何做好呢？ So, just now I heard that those words that spoken by Krishna to gopis, that gopis felt painful. Is it spiritual?
Yes, it's spiritual because it increases, the devotees increase their feelings and affection for Krishna. Their love for Krishna is tested. Everything from Krishna is spiritual. Krishna has, there's nothing in connection with Krishna which is not spiritual.
是灵性的，因为这个就使得牧牛姑娘们对 Krishna 的感受，对 Krishna 的爱恋增加了。这个是一个考试，跟 Krishna 有关的一切都是灵性的，没有什么就是跟 Krishna 有关系的不是灵性的。
Krishna is the absolute truth, so everything from him, all his dealings are absolute. So when he speaks these words, although it appears to be painful, it is actually ecstasy for the gopis.
Krishna is 绝对真理，跟 Krishna 有关系的一切都是绝对的。Krishna 对牧牛姑娘说的话，表面上好像令 Krishna 牧牛姑娘痛苦，但实际上呢，牧牛姑娘内心感觉到的是狂喜。
And the tears which they cry, which appear to be tears of lamentation, are tears of ecstasy.
而且他们的泪水呢，好像是痛苦的泪水，实际上是狂喜的泪水。
第二部分
是I want to please my husband, but the result is contrary. So how can I please my husband?
How can you please your husband? Well, don't try to imitate the gopis and Krishna. You're not Krishna and the gopi. Your husband's not Krishna and you're not a gopi.
不要模仿Krishna 和牧牛姑娘之间的交往。你的丈夫不是 Krishna, 你也不是 gopi 牧牛姑娘。
So, dealings between you and your husband are not like the dealings between Krishna and the gopis. You shouldn't try to imitate. So you can please your husband by speak nice words to him, and you cook food for him, keep the house clean for him, you take care of the children for him, you do that kind of service, that will please your husband.
您可以通过说悦耳动听的话，跟你爱人说好听的话，给他做好吃的食物，把房子打扫干净，然后照顾好孩子，这为他做服务就能取悦他了。
Don't spend all of his money. Try to be economical. Try to be frugal. You'll be happy.
然后不要试图把他钱都花掉、花光。然后要节俭持家，这就能让他的高兴了。So, the next one is
from 下一位叫他说有时候 Krishna 通过痛苦给仁慈，受不了，该怎么办呀？
Krishna sometimes give mercy by making me suffering.So I cannot tolerate it. What should I do?
Krishna makes who suffer? A devotee?
Yes, make this devotee who asks the question.
And she cannot tolerate it.
Tolerate the pain.
So you have to take shelter of Krishna when you have pain, when you're in difficulty. You take shelter of Krishna, and that way then you'll tolerate. If you surrender to Krishna in the times of troubles and difficulties, then you'll overcome all the trouble. The troubles which you're experiencing are all in relation to the material world, the material body and material mind. But if you understand you're not the body, that you're the soul, then you'll overcome all the troubles.
您体验到一些痛苦麻烦都是跟物质世界有关系的，跟物质的身体有关系，跟物质心有关系，但是您是灵魂，如果您觉悟到这一点，您就不会受到打扰了。
So this idea of trouble, this problems, difficulties, this is our mind is making this. The real trouble is to remember Krishna.
所以这些麻烦，这些问题，都是我们的心意，都是源于我们的心意。真正的麻烦是怎么去记忆 Krishna。
If you remember Krishna, then all of these troubles will go away. You'll overcome them all.
如果您能铭记 Krishna, 所有这些麻烦都烟消云散了。下一个是吴秀红。顶拜咕噜莲花族，顶拜奉献者们 ，Hare Krishna， 圣主 Krishna 的超然音阵能净化家人和非奉献者吗 ？Obeisance to the lotus feet of Guru, obeisance to all devotees, Hare Krishna. Can the transcendental sound vibration of Lord Shri Krishna purify my family members and non-devotees?
The holy name purifies everyone.
圣名能净化每个人。
All living entities benefit by the sound vibration of the holy name.
所有的众生都由于圣名的超然音阵而得到了利益处。
So your family members, non-devotees, they can all be greatly benefited by hearing the holy name.
所以您的家人非奉献者都因为聆听到了圣名而得到了巨大的好处。
Yeah, this is the Sankirtan movement to give mercy to everyone.
这是一场 Sankirtan 运动，其中圣名运动是能给每一个生物带来好处的运动。
Yes.
下一个问题来自于张巴巴提 David Dasi， 顶拜咕噜莲花族。请问能冥想 Krishna 的 Rasa 之舞吗 ？Jamabadi asks, obeisance to the Lord, can I meditate on the Krishna's Rasa dance?
Well, you can hear about it.
您可以聆听。
If you've read the other volumes, I think you must have, you've read the other cantos of the Bhagavatam.So then you can read the 10th canto, and there are 5 chapters there. So you can read that, and you can read them again and again.
那么在就是不质量不加把它有很多卷，在第十篇当中有5章就涉及到 Rasa 之舞，您可以阅读一而再再而三的朗读。
Yeah, we are not.Encouraging people in meditation, but we encourage people to chant the holy name and to speak about Krishna.
We don't encourage people to meditate Rasa 之舞，但是我们鼓励人们去唱诵圣名，去讲述 Krishna. The next one.
Yeah.
静华，顶拜您亲爱的 Guru Day 顶拜翻译，请问 Guru， 医生的职责是救死扶伤，帮助他人摆脱痛苦。 是受到欢迎的职责，但是痛苦是业报法则所致，是生物应得的。那医生这个职责是跟主的业报法则唱反调了吗？我该怎么理解呢，亲爱的？对，静华马大吉 ask that the profession of a doctor is to relieve others from suffering. It's a popular profession. Yet karma, the law of karma, but suffering is due to law of karma. It's their share. They should have this suffering.The living entities. So in that sense, the profession of the doctor is contradictory, is opposed to the law of karma. So how can I understand that?
Well, karma is not eternal.
Karma 不是永恒的，业报不是永恒的。
And so we have karma one way, we may have karma, bad karma in the form we have some disease, and we go to the doctor gives some medicine or something, you have to pay some money to the doctor, you have to pay for the medicine, and you have to take some bitter medicine, that's also karma, taking bitter medicine, you know, but we can't really change the karma just by going to the doctor, but the karma will, if it doesn't come through the disease, it will come some other way.
Karma, 业报它不是永恒的。我们去看医生，然后医生给我们开一些药，我们掏钱，然后医生给我们一些很苦的药，我们要服用这些苦药。这也是一个业报 karma， 但是 karma 可以改变。如果这个业报不是通过以疾病的形式出来的话，它会以别的形式展示出来。
Yeah. It may be that you have to spend a lot of money to pay the doctors.
比如说，它会以一种形式，就是您得给医生很多的钱。
The suffering, if we're meant to suffer.The suffering will come some other way.
如果我们意味着我们必须受苦的话，这个苦难会以别的方式展示。
Just simply going to the doctor is not going to take away our karma.
光是去看医生，并不能够把我们的业报拿走。
But.The reaction is going to come one way or another. Therefore, some people, they won't go to doctor. They would just suffer.
这个业报的反应会不是以这种方式来到我们身边，就是另外一种方式来到我们身边。因此有的人就干脆就不去看大夫，他们就是在那里受苦。
The next
one from Chandra Vilasini. 虔诚的顶拜孤对甜美的莲花组。今天早上我读到瓦坛7:4:28，已然卡什普，得到从 Brahma 那里得到祝福，但是由于他冒犯儿子 Prahlad 马哈尔的莲花组，所以他的祝福也无效了。请教孤对，我们是不是该做好自己有好品质，孤鲁圣人自然就给祝福。这种祝福才有效，而不是主动所向圣人索取主动的要祝福。我这样理解对吗？Obeisance to the sweet lotus feet of Guru. This morning I read Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 7, Chapter 4, Verse 28. Hiranyakashipu got blessing from Brahma, yet because he offended his.Son, Prahlad Maharaj, the lotus feet of Prahlad Maharaj, therefore the blessing is nullified. So my question that, Gurudev, should we do our, should we first of all, perfect ourselves? If we have good quality, then Guru, Sadhu, naturally they will bless us. So that kind of blessing will be effective instead of voluntary beg blessing from the sadhu. Is this understanding right?
Well, we cannot perfect ourselves without the blessings of the sadhu.
没有圣人的祝福, 我们也不能, 做好自己, 让我们自己完美。
You cannot just think, I will become perfect, then I will go and see the sadhu. No, but it's by association with the sadhus that we will become perfect.
我们不应该想, 等我那个做好了, 等我完美了, 我再去见圣者, 不是这样的, 我们应该先去见圣者, 然后我们才能做得好, 我们才能完美。 下一个, 来自于Rasa, 最后一个, Rasa, 顶拜Guru, 朋友说, 下辈子, 反正我怎么记不住了, 为什么要修呢? 这辈子快活就行了, 我该怎么回应他呢? So, Rasa, obeisance Guru, my friend said, anyway, I cannot remember, in the next life, I cannot remember anything. So why should I practice? I will simply be happy in this life. So how can I respond to her?
Yes, we want to be happy in this life also. And we want to be happy in this life and in the next life. And we can be happy in this life and in the next life by practicing Krishna consciousness.
是的。 我们这辈子要快乐，我们来世也要快乐，我们是通过修习Krishna知觉而获得快乐的。But
you're thinking you'll be happy without practicing Krishna consciousness? No, you cannot be happy.
可是您觉得没有Krishna知觉您就能快活了吗? 不会的。
So much suffering in the material world. Everyone wants to be happy. Are they happy?
在物质世界有诸多的痛苦，人人都想要获得快乐，但是他们都快乐了吗？
They're suffering now, and they will suffer more in the future.
他们不仅现在在受苦，而且他们来世会受更多的苦。
Because they don't practice Krishna consciousness, they don't know how to properly act. So we're teaching people what is the proper standard of behavior, what is the proper way to live. When we live according to the laws of nature, then we will be happy. But if you're not following the laws of nature, then you will never be happy. You'll just get more and more suffering.
永远不可能快乐，而且会有越来越多的痛苦。
Somebody thinks, oh, I'll be happy, I can eat anything, I'll be happy, I will eat meat. Yeah, you eat meat, that means you kill animals, you let people kill animals for you. The animal suffers, and because the animal suffers, you will suffer.
你会想，我就吃肉吧，但是吃肉呢，就会要杀死那些动物。 而且呢，通过吃肉，你就允许了别人来杀戮动物，因为这些动物受苦了，你也会感到痛苦的。If
we give suffering to others, we will suffer ourselves.
我们给别人带来痛苦，我们自己也会，受苦。
We have been given so much by the grace of Krishna. Krishna has provided all the facilities in this world for us.
我们Krishna 在这个世界上给我们提供了这么多的生活设施。
He is the proprietor. He is like our landlord. And we have to pay taxes. We have to pay rent to him.
他是拥有者，他就好像我们的房东。我们应该给他付税，我们应该给他钱。
If we are simply living and enjoying the facilities and we don't recognize the actual owner, then we will get reactions.
如果我们只是住在，就是住在这房子里享受，然后也不给房东、房主钱的话，那么我们不会快乐的。
He will come. He'll kick you out. Get out. You can't stay here anymore. Get out from here.
然后房主就会来把我们从这个房子里赶出去。你别再住在这里头了。
So we have the human body, human life. It's a great opportunity. We should use it very carefully to practice Krishna consciousness.
我们现在已经有了这个人体。我们应当特别小心，我们应当用这个人体生命的机会来修习 Krishna 之觉。
So we say chant and be happy, but if you don't chant, how will you be happy? You drink alcohol, will that make you happy? That is total ignorance.
我们应当唱诵并快乐，但是如果我们不唱诵，怎么能变得快乐呢？如果喝酒，这个酗酒是完全的愚昧。
Okay, moment. 还有问题吗？
最后一个刀吉，
刀吉，
刀吉大喜。刀吉，Hare Krishna， 顶戴 Guru Dev 莲花族，顶戴，在一个各位 Vaishnava。奉献者莲花族，业报不是永恒，命运可以改变的，对吧？那如何理解经典中所讲的定数？请咕噜开示，感恩您。Hare Krishna, obeisance Guru, lotus feet, obeisance to all Vaishnava. Since karma, the Lord karma, since karma.Karma is not eternal, then the destiny can also be changed, right? In that way, how can we understand? 定数 How can we understand destiny in the scripture? I beg Guru to reveal that.
Well, that we have one destiny if we haven't surrendered to Krishna. When we don't surrender to Krishna, there's one destiny. And when you surrender to Krishna, then there's a different destiny.
如果我们不臣服 Krishna, 就有着一种命运。如果我们臣服了 Krishna, 就有另外一种命运。
Once we surrender to Krishna, then everything is changed.
一旦我们臣服了 Krishna, 那一切都改变了。
All the karmas changed, all the karmas destroyed by devotional service.
所有的业报都因为奉献服务而被这些业报都被摧毁。
Then we become really lucky, really fortunate once we have surrendered to Krishna.
一旦我们臣服 Krishna, 我们就变得真正的幸运了。
Then we're under the protection of the divine energy. Krishna is taking care of us under the control of Krishna.
这之后我们处在神圣能量的保护之下， Krishna 就会照顾我们。
So we're either controlled by Krishna by the spiritual energy, or we're controlled by Krishna by the material energy, the Maya.
我们或者是被Krishna 通过灵性能量所控制，或者是 被 Krishna 通过物质能量 Maya 控制着。
So we're always controlled.
所以无论哪种情况，我们都是受到控制的。
I hope that helps you to understand.
我希望这个回答能够能够帮助你理解。
Dauji Dasi, Hare Krishna. Okay, 还有问题吗？
没有了 ，Guru Dev， 今天的问题都解答完了。
Okay， 今天我们讲到这里，祝福你们，圣诞节快乐，新年快乐，多保重，注意身体，感谢萨提。就是感谢 Guru Mani 给我们精彩的翻译 Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna 感谢 Guru Day 的讲课感谢大家的聆听
OK See you next week Hare Krishna 下个星期见、啊、
好的